Now, let's see how to implement the delete option. Delete like we want to delete the existing record from the DB. Suppose here we have the 20th record and one record we want to delete. So as I explained earlier, all these, that is create, update, delete and get, works with single record only. So just like for getting a single record, we pass the primary key. So in the same way, for deleting the record, we have to pass the key field. So for example, this is our key value, that is the last one, 2735 or VB alien, and we want to delete this record. So for that, go to our DPC extension class. Here, for the respective entity set, re-implement the delete entity. Change mode, select, redefine. So this time, if you see here, as in the create and the update, we were having the IO underscore provider method. But here for delete, we have to read the parameter, that is the key value, from this IT underscore key tab, which we have used at the time of get entity implementation. So first, we have to read this input table into the work area with the primary key. So if you see here, here we have name and this value. So in the name, we'll get the key field, that is the VBELN, and in value, we'll get the SO number. Go back. So this time, I will also try to use the new web syntax. So let's say read key field. So I will write read table, that is IT underscore key tab, into with the new web syntax, that is data, let's say GS underscore key tab with key, that is a name, equal to VBELN. If GS underscore, let's say key tab value is not initial, and if again declare a local variable, that is LV underscore VBELN equal to this GS underscore key value, and delete from Z table, delete from Z OVBAK, where VBELN equals to LV underscore VBELN. Save, check, one error. Values, it is value, not value. One more error, it is value, not values. Now no error. Save, check and activate. Go to display mode, put a breakpoint here. Go back under service maintenance, click on maintain. SAP Gateway client. Let me first select the record which I want to delete, ending with 2735. Select the entity set. Pass a key value which we want to delete. And select the delete radio button. Click on execute. So the breakpoint get triggered, that is delete entity. To check the values, double click on IT underscore key tab. So here we can see for the VBLN the value which is passed from the URL. Press F5. Yes, the value is found. Data delete from VBAK, press F8. 204, that is in green color, this means it is success. So how to confirm? Just go back 28 record ending with 735, just click on refresh. We can see 27 now, the last record is successfully deleted. So in this way we have seen how to create a new project into the Getter Builder. We have also seen how to create the data model, different input types with the manual option, as well as with the DDIC import concepts. And we have seen all how to generate runtime objects, how to implement the different methods, how to register and maintain the service, and especially as the basic concepts which consist of the CRUD operation, that is select filter here, that is the get entity, create, delete, get entity set, and update entity. So we have successfully done with these all basic concepts. So this is the basic level OLTA concepts. So once we are familiar with this, do practice by creating a different data model in all. And once we are done with these basic concepts, then we have to go for the next level, that is, let's say, working with the query options, dollar filter, dollar escape, dollar top, and also like association, navigation, and creating data with the deep entity sets. That all we can divide into the advanced part. And till now, whatever we have done, this CRUD operation, this is called the completely basic OData. So after this last implementation of delete, we have successfully done with the basic of OData concepts. Thank you.